It is possible to supplement existing, naturally occurring populations of beneficials by releasing parasitoids. This process jump-starts their population growth in the early summer and can be effective in managing fly populations if certain conditions are met. First, sanitation and waste management are a must. Parasitoid releases complement sanitation and manure management practices, but they do not replace them. Second, when insecticides are necessary for supplemental fly control, only insecticides that are compatible with parasitoids should be used. Parasitoids are sold as immature insects in killed fly pupae. Local suppliers ship the parasitoids in cheesecloth bags. If most fly breeding on the farm occurs inside the barn, these bags should be hung on posts and rafters near areas where fly breeding is a problem. For releases made in calf areas, at least a portion of the contents of each bag, approximately 1,000 pupae or 3 heaping teaspoons, should be distributed in each hutch weekly. Many companies that sell parasitoids advertise their products in farm magazines, but not all of them sell the correct species or provide parasitoids that are adapted for the northeastern climate. Before purchasing parasitoids, ask a few questions to determine if you're obtaining the right species and one that is adapted for the climate in the northeast. Musidophorax raptor is the species recommended for use in the northeast. Nasonia parasitoids are inexpensive, but are inappropriate for use in dairies. Start releasing parasitoids in mid to late May and continue weekly until mid-August. How many parasitoids should be released? Weekly releases of either 200 parasitoids per milking cow or 1,000 parasitoids per calf have proven effective. But every farm is different, and you may need to adjust release rates and schedules to achieve a level that is both effective and affordable. How cost-effective are parasitoid releases? Prices vary, but the average is about $13 per batch of 10,000 parasitoids plus shipping charges. At a release rate of 200 per cow per week, total costs for the summer are between $2.60 and $4.70 per cow, depending on how long parasitoid releases are sustained. In research trials, the cost of releasing parasitoids has been more than offset by a reduction in insecticide treatments. On average, dairy farmers who use an integrated approach to fly management by incorporating biological control with sanitation and other cultural practices make 80% fewer insecticide applications than farmers who rely solely on insecticides. In addition, fly populations on IPM farms are about 50% lower than on conventionally managed farms. It is important, however, to understand that no single fly management strategy, such as parasitoid releases alone, will provide long-term control. Has the process of releasing parasitoids been perfected? We are still at an early stage in understanding how to best use biological control in fly management programs. If you would like to share your observations, successes, and disappointments with us so that we can all learn together, contact your local cooperative extension educator or regional specialist, or write to Cornell's Veterinary Entomology Program or the New York State IPM Program at Cornell. The addresses will appear at the end of this video. Insecticides can play an important role in integrated fly management programs. Chemical control options include space sprays, baits, larvicides, residual premise sprays, pour-ons, and whole animal sprays. Carefully read and understand pesticide labels before using them. This is particularly important when treating lactating animals. Some materials are labeled for use on animals, while others require animals to not be present at the time of application. Space sprays provide a quick knockdown of adult flies in an enclosed airspace. Because pyrethrin-based space sprays have very little residual activity, fly populations in the Northeast are still relatively susceptible to them. Baits are also very useful for managing moderate fly populations. Space sprays and baits are compatible with fly parasitoids, allowing parasitoid populations to increase and be available later in the summer when they will be needed the most. If needed, space sprays and baits should be used for early season fly control. Several insecticides are labeled for use as larvicides, either for direct treatment of manure or in controlled release formulations. Controlled release larviciding options include boluses and feed additives that result in the insecticides being excreted with animal feces. Direct applications of insecticides to manure and bedding should be avoided because of harmful effects on natural enemies. The only exception is occasional spot treatment of breeding sites that are heavily infested with fly larvae. Treatment of building surfaces with residual sprays has been one of the most popular fly control strategies over the years. Houseflies, unfortunately, have developed high levels of resistance to these insecticides. They should be used only as a last resort, late in the season, to control only fly outbreaks that cannot be managed with other techniques. Pour-ons and whole animal sprays are applied directly to animals. Although they provide animals with relief from stable fly bites, their control is short-lived. Whichever insecticide you choose, be sure to alternate insecticide use with an insecticide having a different active ingredient to slow the development of insecticide resistance. Check insecticide labels closely. The same active ingredient may be marketed under different trade names. Resistance problems develop and are aggravated by chronic use of the same insecticide or the same active ingredient. It is important to switch insecticides between each application. For current pesticide information, contact your local cooperative extension office. This video has presented an integrated approach to managing housefly and stable fly populations in and around dairy livestock facilities. We hope you better understand the biology of houseflies and stable flies and are more familiar with fly life cycles and their vulnerable stages. We have demonstrated how sanitation and cultural practices play a critical role in protecting animal health and minimizing fly populations. We encourage you to evaluate management practices and select management alternatives that can reduce fly populations while protecting beneficial populations. We hope you understand how to conserve and augment populations of beneficial predators and parasitoids, such as Musidophorax raptor, and will use pesticides only when needed and employ practices that minimize the risk of developing insecticide resistance. We have seen how fly populations can affect animal health and performance and be a problem for farm workers and off-farm neighbors. We've also seen how moist organic matter provides a perfect place for fly development. We identified where favorable fly breeding habitats are found on the typical dairy farm. We discussed methods for monitoring fly populations, such as bait traps, fly ribbons, and fly paper. Also spot cards and actual counts on individual animals. We emphasize the importance of using a combination of cultural, biological, and chemical management practices for effective fly management. Effective management of houseflies and stable flies requires an integrated approach. Success is possible using the information and techniques outlined in this video. Good luck with your fly management efforts.